We're here at Hurlburt Field on the Florida Panhandle, the home base of Air Force Special Operations Command. AFSOC flies a number of unique aircraft, and one of them is the CV-22 Osprey Tilt Rotor. It's a variant of the MV-22 that the Marines fly off of ships, except for AFSOC has modified it to support their unique special operations missions. The primary advantage of the CV-22 Osprey is that it can be flown both like a helicopter and like an airplane. I'm Jay Bennett with Popular Mechanics, and we're going to go talk to a CV-22 pilot to learn a little bit more about this unique aircraft.
The V-22 is, you know, the first of its kind. The transition for both fixed-wing and helicopter pilots has its challenges. For fixed-wing guys, learning how to hover an airplane and fly it like a helicopter is a challenge, and then vice versa for guys like me who come from helicopter backgrounds, learning how to go fast again and fly an airplane is a challenge. The speed at which things are happening, being able to think, you know, 2, 4, 5 miles ahead of the airplane as opposed to only 1 or 2 miles, the rate at which you need to make decisions and decide what you're going to do with the aircraft speeds up.
And I was wondering if you kind of describe to me the way it transitions from, you know, helicopter mode to plane mode.
We try to make it, I guess gradual is not the right word, but seamless and smooth as possible. So the transition is primarily based on airspeed, where we're essentially taking the lift created by the rotor system and transitioning it from the rotor to the wings as you speed up. So most fixed wing pilots will tell you that airspeed is life, and most helicopter pilots will tell you that rotor speed is life. So figuring out the speed at which to transition the engines forward between one and the other is where that kind of that secret lies. You know, it's the same as any typical helicopter speed. So basically from, you know, 0 to about 120, 130 knots is where you're going to primarily act as a helicopter. And then about 140 knots all the way up to 240 knots is where you're going to kind of live in that airplane regime of flight. You can absolutely feel that transition from, you know, vertical flight to horizontal flight as an airplane. So sitting up front, you know, you're sitting facing forward in the seat. As those rotors come down, you can feel that, you know, the wing takes over the lift, and then those rotors are 100% dedicated to getting you up and moving as fast as possible, mm-hmm. as quickly as possible. So you'll feel a little bit of a push into the seat, a little bit of shift in your kind of angle of, you know, angle of flight on the horizon. Primary mission it was designed for was to do long-range infiltration and exfiltration, and also resupply of those forces that we put in. Can also, you know, be called to do any number of other events, humanitarian relief. We can land on ships just like the MV-22s can. So,
crew of four typically.
Two pilots is responsible for the entire aft cabin. So whether it be making sure that our teams are properly secured, whether the cargoes that we're taking out is properly loaded, manning the 50 caliber machine gun that we have mounted on the tail, or running our hoist. Out the back in the event of some kind of you know, rescue scenario where we can't land and still have to get somebody out of a hostile environment, right? It's the first tilt rotor, it's the first gen technology, so, you know, with that is going to obviously come developmental learning points. With that said, I don't know anybody in the squadron or anybody in the community that doesn't, you know, trust the airplane. You know, we're not going to go put ourselves into an aircraft that we think is unsafe or unreliable to fly.